The Lord did something for her during the prophetic weekend, and she wants to testify to the glory of God. I want good volume on that mic. Amen? All right. The Lord did something. What did God do for you?
So I'm going to start explaining what happened before I came here to church. On October 1st, I got in an accident. But this first accident, it was a minor one. I got away with it. And then the second one, apparently I had taken my actual vehicle to my dealer to fix it. And he gave me his own van. When he gave me his van to drive, we didn't actually clarify about the insurance. He just said, oh, take this van. I know it's insured. It's okay. You can go with it. So as I was going with the van, the van had a problem. And I said, I'm taking back the van to him. On my way driving back to the dealer, that is before I even came here to church. So on my way now, I was going, driving to return the van, and I hit someone's car again.
My Lord. How many accidents in a month?
Two accidents. And I was devastated. It was serious. I've never gotten in an accident before. It's my first time. So this time, this accident was bad. Nobody was hurt, but all the cars were ruined. The person's car who I hit, who was making a U-turn, and I was behind him. The van, which was not my van, the dealer's van, got it was total damage, both cars. And so here I was standing on the road. I only managed to call the owner of the car and I told him, I got in an accident, this is what happened. And he said, oh, you got in an accident, okay, just make sure you give everything you have to the police, just give them the information you have. And apparently he didn't send me the vehicle information about his car. So on that time, I was alone. And the police came. When the police came, they said, we are giving you two tickets. When they had all the explanation, they said, the first ticket, you were following too closely to this guy's car. So we are giving you $274. And I said, OK, this one is fine. Then they gave me the second conviction. They said, no financial responsibility of the vehicle. And now on this ticket.
So what does that mean? It means that you are not the owner of the vehicle?
And the vehicle is not insured.
Oh, the vehicle is not insured.
My Lord. Yeah, I'm not the owner, and also the vehicle is not insured. And they said the second conviction had about $300-something. And they said, if you don't provide on the day of citation, if you don't provide information that this vehicle was insured, we are suspending your license, or you are going to jail because it's like a crime. And here I am, I work at a distribution company. It's a distribution company. They don't want any driving problems. If you don't have a license, they suspend you. And now I was at home, I didn't know what to do. That's when I decided to come to church.
Hey, you came here because you had problems. Somebody say God of results.
God of results.
So she decided to come here because she's going to court.
Yes, I really say this.
You needed prayers.
Yes.
You needed a miracle.
I say,
by the way, what is your name?
Tanaka. Yes.
So you needed a miracle, so you decided to come. How did you know about this church?
Actually, Pastor Mama Gigi, she's my mom, and Pastor Lemo, they are close to me. They are like a family. I used to live with them. So she invited me a while back.
You didn't come when you didn't have problems.
Yes, she invited me. So this time I said, I said to myself, I have this problem. I need a prophet because this situation I will not.
Hey, I have a problem. I need a prophet.
Amen.
My God.
That's what I said to myself because I knew there was no getting away with this situation. And I came on during the prophetic weekend on Wednesday. So I texted Mama Gigi. I said, Mama Gigi, please, can you send me the address of the church? So she sent me the picture where she said, Wednesday and Sun. I said, oh my God, I'm going to come to church. So on Wednesday, I came to church and I was sitting on this side. So I came to church. I said, I'm not giving up. Let me continue coming. And I was just, I hadn't really learned anything. So I was just trying, you know, just trying and saying, let me just come to church and see what happens. And I was waiting. So I continued coming. I continued coming till on the day of my citation. So apparently Sunday, we had Sunday, the previous Sunday, we had the Talik Sunday. And so our man of God was teaching about the talits, about the name of God, about believing in the word, reading the
and
word.
And holding on to the name
yes.
of the Lord.
Holding on to the name of God.
Despite the challenges.
Yes. So I was, when I came, I could tell you, since the accident happened on October, on all the weekend, I was coming. Even I wasn't having sleep. I was, but when our man of God was teaching about holding on the name of God, something changed inside of me. I was just still. And then when I purchased my talik, I went home and I kept on praying as we were told to. I kept on holding the strings of the talik. And so on the day of citation Monday, last week Monday, I said to my mom, apparently my mom, she's not a believer, my family, they don't believe. But I said, Mama, can you just go with me to court? I'm so afraid, I don't know what's going to happen to me there. So she apparently went with me. She saw me wearing a talik.
You wore your talit to court.
Wow. Yes.
Somebody put your hands together for the Lord. And when you got there, what did they say? You were coming into court in a talit.
So when I was going out, apparently what happened is, I was wearing my talit. My mom was just looking at me. She was like, what? I think you are now, you are so afraid and you are acting like a child of a sambo. Because you have so many things on you. That's what she was saying. Because I was so paranoid when I was driving, I was holding the talik all over me and I was holding the string. She kept looking and she said, I think you are becoming too religious. And I said, you know what, it's okay. Very soon you will have faith. You see what happens.
My God. Yeah.
So as we parked at the court, there was a Jewish man. I could tell he was Jewish looking at him. He was coming off the court. And for me, it was weird because I wasn't expecting to see anyone who knows about the talik. That man looked at me and he was like, where did you get that? And I said, then my mom now, she know, oh, so this is church. She now would start to believe. And I said, yes, I'm Jewish too. So I tried to extend my hand. You know, they don't greet people. They just bow their head. So he bowed his head and I was like, oh. Then I said, oh, me, I got it from church. I'm Jewish too. Then he was like, okay, bless you. And then he went. So we went into the court and I was so nervous because the lady who was taking care of the case, she didn't start with the one of following too closely. She started with one with no insurance.
With a higher one.
Yes. And now
and that's the one that was supposed to take you to jail.
Yes. And apparently when I went there still, I still don't have proof of insurance. I went there without proof of that.
So your proof of insurance was the talit. So you took your talit as proof.
Yes, I was still wearing my talit. So I said, I don't have proof of insurance. The only insurance I have is for my vehicle, the one which is I don't even have. So I went in there, she said, do you have insurance right now? That's the question she asked. I didn't ask about that vehicle. And I said, yes, I have insurance. Then she said, oh, okay, that's fine. Give me that one. I gave her the insurance I had, not the one which was being requested. And she called my insurance. She said, was this person insured? Then they said, yes, she was insured. Then they said, okay, fine. We are filing for dismissal.
Wow! My God, somebody put your hands together for the Lord. My God, said the case was dismissed. Somebody say, oh Lord, all the charges against me,
all
the kingdom of darkness, be canceled and dismissed. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and pray for 30 seconds right now. Any charge against you, whatever the devil has against you, whatever your enemies have against you, I decree and declare today, let that be dismissed in the name of Jesus. You are acquitted by the blood of Jesus. You are acquitted in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And then what happened after that?
And I was shocked. My mom was, we looked at each other. And they said, oh my God. And I was still holding on my talik. And they said, we are removing this case. This doesn't make sense. You have insurance. You are insured. No worries. And then she said, okay, the second, now let's go to the second one. And the second one, I rushed to say, oh, let me pay quickly the payment right now. And she said, no, if you agree to pay on it right now, you are agreeing on the crime, so they won't remove it on your record. Now we see your driver's record, we just want you to pay half of it. And then
Amen.
You take a test, then we remove it from your record. So I only paid half of the charge of following too closely. And I really thank God because that was a miracle.
Somebody put your hands together one more time for the Lord. We give God a glory this morning. Somebody put your hands and just begin to praise the Lord this morning. Say, Heavenly Father, show yourself in my life. Show yourself in my life. Do a miracle for me. Even those of you that are watching us today, you can believe God now to discharge, to acquit whatever it is that is against you. Whatever your enemies have against you can be dismissed today in the name of Jesus. Our God is a miracle working God. Our God is a miracle working God. In the name of Jesus, our God is a miracle working God. Father, we thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, as you go, more favor will follow you this season, especially as the festive seasons begin. May God prove himself in your life even more and more. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody say amen.
Amen.